the Adopt Pet Show. Today is Monday, June the 6th. My name is Jeanette Higgins, and I'm a volunteer with the Noonan Coweta Humane Society. And what our group does is we come down here to Coweta County Animal Control, located off of Selt Road, that is spelled S-E-L-T, in Noonan. And we showcase as many of their little fur kids and fur babies as we can get on the show in this segment in hopes that someone out there watching will absolutely fall in love and want to rush on down and adopt a pet. So stay tuned, folks, because the best is yet to come. Hey, guys, we are doing things a little different here this morning because we are playing with these silly puppies and we're just having so much fun. We've got two boys and a girl. The girl is Hannah. And I believe this is Hannah with the little stripe down her face. Yes, we've got Hannah. We've got Pee-wee. There goes Hannah. We've got Pee-wee, who's the little guy. And then we've got Spot, who, of course, is the guy with a spot on his head. And we have who was it that took off? Hannah took off, and she's running around the room. Here she comes.
She is.
But we just thought it'd be more fun instead of just sitting on the bench, letting you guys see how cute these little guys are and gals. They are only about 2 months old. They're all boxer mixes, hanging out in, it looks like A13 is their kennel number. They were all picked up as strays from Joseph Hanna Boulevard, and just as cute as they can be, folks. And I tell you what, oh my goodness, who can resist these little puppy faces? Look at that face, oh my goodness. They are so cute and so sweet and so young and so much fun. What a great thing to do for your children that are home this summer to learn some responsibility and be able to take care of one of these little fun darlings. But they're absolutely adorable, folks. So if you're ready for a puppy, add it to your home, come down, get Hannah, Pee-wee, or Spot, because all these little darlings are waiting for their new forever home, and they are waiting for you down here at Coweta County Animal Control. This beautiful girl. This is Lucinda. She is our girl that is dressed up in a tuxedo. We like to call these kitty cats tuxedo kitty cats when they have the black and white markings like Lucinda does. And this beautiful girl is only about 3 years old. She is hanging out in C1. That's her cat condo number. And she was picked up as a stray from Peyton Drive. No collar, no ID. And folks, because Lucinda has been here since the beginning of May, this girl here has been here, gosh, almost a month. So we always get a little nervous here as to whether or not animal control is going to put out a euthanasia list. And right now we don't know of one, but it could happen in the very near future. And we don't want to see that happen with pretty Lucinda. She's very calm. You know, she got a little nervous when there was another cat out in the room. She just wasn't really sure if she liked that or not. But she is a very sweet cat, as you can see, hanging out with our volunteer Jamie and our other junior volunteer Jake here. Lucinda is a really cool girl, just hanging out and checking out the room and just wants to be pretty much a lap cat. So if you're interested in Lucinda, she is down here at Animal Control just waiting to be your best friend and to have a forever home. Excited to be here. Listen to her. She just wants to come and get her. This is June, and June is a Chow Chow mix. She's about a year and a half old, hanging out in B14. She was picked up as a stray from Midway Road. No collar, no ID. She's heartworm negative. And I tell you what, it is the month of June, and it is her month. It is her month to find her new forever home, folks, and you gotta come down and meet this girl. She is very, very excited. So happy to be out of the kennel, loves to be around people, and is just a beautiful girl inside and out. So if you're interested in June, please do hurry on down here and give this girl a home this month. This month of June is her month. Here, Clyde, and he is very sweet, guys. He's purring and happy and got a little nervous coming out here in the bonding room area because it can be quite loud with the dog kennel area right behind us. But Clyde is just chilling now in our volunteer Jamie's lap. Now, I believe he's at least a year old, although it doesn't say it on his card, but we do know that he is hanging out in C3. That's his cat condo number, and he was picked up as a stray. It says Highway 100. I'm not really sure if there's a highway. I've never even heard of Highway 100, but we will double check that and make sure that that is correct before we do the show next week. But actually, I'm hoping Clyde will be adopted, and he won't be here when we come do the show next week. Because this sweetheart doesn't need to be here one more day, folks. He's a really nice boy. He loves to snuggle. He's just an absolute sweetheart. So if you're interested in Clyde, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control and make this guy just as happy as he can possibly be by adopting him and taking him home. He is down here waiting for you. Hey guys, I tell you what, this girl has the nickname Lucky, and I tell you what, not only would she be lucky if you adopted her, but you would be really lucky too because she is a wonderful girl. She's still a puppy, only about 9 or 10 months old. She's a lab retriever mix, and she loves to give lots of puppy kisses. Look at that goofy face she's giving us now. She is just silly, but sweet. Oh my goodness, she will not stop giving puppy kisses, and she likes to give hugs too. I was trying to put the bandana on her, and she jumped up in my arms and was trying to give me a big hug. So she is very, very sweet, folks. Now, this girl was picked up as a stray from the Beverly Park area. They scanned her, no ID, and she is heartworm negative. She's had all of her shots. She's been dewormed. And our volunteer, Ritu, here was telling me that Lucky is so smart. She knows some basic commands out in the yard area. She is just smart and beautiful and just the epitome of the perfect dog. So I tell you what, Lucky is a perfect name for this girl because she is a lucky girl, and like I said, you will be lucky if you get to come adopt her and take her home. So hurry on down, folks, because this girl's a special gem, and you don't want her, you don't want to miss the opportunity to take her home to your family because she's going to make a great dog and someone very, very happy. So come on down and rescue Lucky. It is actually going to be featured at PetSmart because the Humane Society has now been given permission to house some of the pets that we have up for adoption at PetSmart. So Calliope here, even though she's here at Animal Control, we don't want people to get confused. She's not gonna be at Animal Control past today, and today is Monday, June 6th. She is going to be featured as one of the kitty cats at PetSmart in Newnan. So if you are interested in this girl, you'll need to rush over to PetSmart in Newnan, rather here to Animal Control to meet her. She's beautiful, folks. Calico, I can hear her purring, and I'm sitting a couple people away from her, and I can hear her purring, and I can tell that she's got gorgeous fur, that feather duster tail, beautiful markings. Now, Calliope is still a kitten. She's only about 4 months old, and she was picked up as a stray from Boone Drive. So, like I said, she's a special girl that we just love so much that we want to go ahead and rescue her as a rescue group, and we're taking her to PetSmart in Newnan, where she will be housed until she's adopted there. So if you're interested in this gorgeous girl, Calliope, then hurry on down to PetSmart in Newnan and make her your own. So hurry on down and rescue, well, not rescue because we're rescuing her, but hurry on down and adopt Calliope. Nervous to be out here in the bonding room area, but who can blame him? I mean, Django here did nothing wrong to end up at Animal Control except simply get lost. So he was picked up as a stray from Peachtree Landings Subdivision, no collar. He's about a year and a half old, and Django here is in B5, that's his kennel number. And I tell you what, his poor little tail is just tucked right between those legs. He's so scared. But folks, these poor dogs and even the cats that come in here, they, like I said, they didn't do anything wrong. They just got lost and ended up being picked up by Animal Control, and they don't know why they're here. And the last thing that they want to do is stay here because they want to be in a home. So that's why we do what we do, trying to save these guys and give them homes. But Django here, I do need to mention, is heartworm positive. But folks, that's not the end of the road for this boy. I will say it to the end of time, that is not the end of the road for these dogs that end up with heartworms. You just get them heartworm treatments done at a local veterinarian's office, and then get them on heartworm preventative, and they are good to go. Now, Django here, they have him marked as a pit bull, but we're thinking he's some sort of lab mix, pit bull, boxer mix, something like that. He's definitely a mix of some different breeds, but such a nice, pretty honey color to his coat, such a nice, healthy boy, and just needs somebody to give him some extra TLC and show him that humans are not bad and that we're gonna love on him and not hurt him, and that he can have all the love that he so deserves. So come on down, folks, and rescue Django. He's down here just waiting for you. This is Joseph. He is so adorable. This little orange male tabby. Oh my goodness, so sweet and so innocent and so tiny. What a cutie pie. This guy is only about 2 months old. He's hanging out in C7. That's his kitten condo number. And this boy was picked up as a stray from Peachtree Landing Subdivision. Of course, no collar, because my goodness, how can you put a collar on that thing? He's so tiny. But he's very vocal. I can hear him making all kinds of noises, and he's hanging out in our little junior volunteer's lap, Jake here. But Joseph is just a cutie pie, folks. And I tell you what, there's more and more kittens coming in here to Animal Control, but don't wait, because they get snatched up really quickly, because everybody, you know, you can't resist a cat or kitten rather, or a puppy. They're just so adorable, and so they don't really last long here. They get adopted really quickly. So don't wait if you see this little guy and you're falling in love, because he may not be here very long, because somebody out there also, who was watching the show, is saying, what a little stinking cutie pie that is, and I'm going to go get him today. His eyes are still blue, but we can't guarantee they'll stay blue, folks. Most kittens, I think all kittens are born with blue eyes, but they usually change over. And we can tell you, though, that orange male tabbies have been known to be extremely affectionate, and I'm sure that Joseph is not going to be any exception to that. He's going to be just as sweet and adorable and loving as any orange male tabby ever was. So if you're interested in this little cutie pie, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue him, because, you know, he needs to be in a home with people loving on him and giving him lots of attention rather than all by himself, because right now he's all by himself in a cage. So come on down and rescue Joseph. This little cutie pie is just waiting for you. Okay, folks, we're getting lots of kisses here from this puppy girl. This is Piper. She's hanging out in A11. Now, this girl, they have her marked as a Rottweiler mix, but folks, she's got the markings of what we would consider to be a Rottweiler, but because she has the long, round body and the short legs, that's more of what you would see in a Welsh Corgi. And then also her coloring, what I was told by our volunteer Anne here, is that her coloring is the same as what a Manchester Terrier would be as well. They also, or even just a miniature Doberman Pinscher, they have the same black and tan coloring as a Rottweiler. So we don't really know what all she's made up of, but she definitely has the personality of a Welsh Corgi. She is very, very affectionate. She's just sweet. Her fur is very similar to that of a Welsh Corgi, and they are very affectionate, nice dogs. And not that there's anything wrong with a Rottweiler. I've owned Rottweilers, and I had a Rottweiler that was a big teddy bear. So I can tell you that it's all in the way that you raise them. But this girl is just precious, folks. Oh my goodness, she's gorgeous and she's sweet. She was picked up as a stray from Old Carrollton Road. She is heartworm negative. She's had her shot. She's been dewormed. And she is just a honey of a girl. And you know, she's not going to get much bigger because her paws are not very big. And she does have very short legs. So definitely some sort of Welsh Corgi with whatever black and tan markings she has come up with. But just a sweet girl, as you can see. Look at the kisses and the love that she loves to give to our volunteer, Anne. I mean, she is just a wonderful dog. So if you're interested in Piper, she is down here at Animal Control just waiting for you to give her a new forever home. She is hanging out in C15. She is about 2 years old. And I tell you what, this jet black fur that she has is stunning. I mean, she is definitely a looker. This fur is so shiny and beautiful, and she's got the feather duster tail going on. She's marked as a short-haired, but she's definitely more of a long-haired kitty cat. I know. And she's like, what? Short-haired? No. Did they look at her? She definitely is very fluffy and has long fur. She's got big, beautiful green eyes. She was picked up as a stray from Little Road. So she is just ready for her new home, folks. She definitely is ready to be away from the dog kennel area where she can hear the dogs barking. It's making her very, very nervous. But gorgeous, folks. Silky, shiny, beautiful coat. So we know she's very, very healthy and just a gorgeous girl. So if you're interested in Carrie, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue this beautiful girl. Her bacon treat. So now she's just looking to see where the next bacon treat is coming from. But Loretta here is about a year old. She is a black and white, obviously, pit bull mix. Now, Loretta is in B12, that's her kennel number, and she was picked up as a stray from Highland Park Court. Now, this girl is heartworm negative, which is what we love to hear, and her tail stopped wagging. It was wagging like crazy before. Come on, let's get that tail going again. You're gonna get that tail going again. But she has had all of her shots, and she's been dewormed, and she is just ready to go to her new home. So if you're interested in Loretta, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control. This girl down here is such a, there goes that tail. There goes that happy tail. So she is just really sweet, folks. You gotta come down and meet her. And I wanted to mention that if you have a dog at home and you wanna add another dog to your home, you are welcome to bring your own personal pet down here to Animal Control. Just make sure it's up to date on its vaccinations. And then you can bring your dog down here and take one dog at a time from the kennel area into this room that we sit in called the bonding area. And then you can see how well your dog does with another dog if you want to add another one to your home. And the workers here can certainly help you with that as well. But that way you can find out if there's a love connection between the family and the pet that you already have with the new pet that you want to add. And that way everybody gets to go home happy. So if you're interested in Loretta, like I said, she's down here at Animal Control hanging out in B12, just waiting for somebody to come and rescue her. So come on down and save Loretta. I am holding little China here, and then we have another female with the name of Onyx, and then we have two boys that are Hulk and Hogan. So we have a little group of wrestling little kitties here, these little sweet little kittens. They look like they're only about 4 weeks old, folks. They're very, very small. And all these little sweethearts are hanging out in C26. That is their kitten condo number. They were all picked up as strays from McDonnell Road, and they're all ready for adoption now. Now, because there's four of them, of course, we want to make sure that they all get home. So if there's anybody that can take two at a time, that would be fabulous, because they're so little that they really need somebody else to keep them warm and snuggle with at night. And it's always good for these little babies to go home two at a time. But certainly if you can take one, and then you know people that can take three others, we just want to make sure that these little precious sweethearts all get homes and that none of them get left behind. So if you're interested in China, Onyx, Hulk, or Hogan, all these little sweeties are very fluffy and cute. They look like they might end up being medium-haired kitty cats. Probably not short-haired. And this little China is just sweet, folks. I tell you what, they're all sweet little cute kittens, and they all need a home. So if you're interested in any one of them, then please do hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue these little sweethearts. They're down here waiting for you, and their life depends on you adopting them. Charlotte is a tri-color terrier mix. She's hanging out in B7, that's her kennel number. She's only about 8 months old, so she still has some puppy energy in her. And our volunteer Michaela is trying to get her to come over here. Come on, Cookie.
Hi, Cookie.
Cookie, don't leave the room. Come on, girl. She is just so sweet, folks. I love her curly cute tail and her markings. She looks like she really could be a real cookie or a candy bar or something like that, and she's definitely sweet enough for it. She doesn't want to sit still for 1 minute, but that's the puppy energy she has. This girl is heartworm negative. She's had all of her shots. She's been dewormed. She was picked up as a stray from Lake Hills Subdivision wearing a pink collar. And she is just ready for her new home, and I have a feeling that she's going to want a home that she can run in that backyard and burn off some of the energy. But now, look at her. She's pretending like she's chill. So I guess she really, truly can be a laid-back dog. But she is just very excited, of course, to be here and to be around all these people that are loving on her and walking her around, and she's enjoying being out of that kennel for sure. So if you're interested in Cookie, like I said, she's a real sweetheart. And she obviously can also be very chilled. She can chill out, yes she can, but as soon as somebody pays attention to her, then she just starts getting all excited again. So folks, come on down here and rescue Cookie. She's down here at Animal Control, just waiting to be your new best friend. Recognize this handsome fella. This is Luke. He is definitely one of our volunteer favorites here at Animal Control. He's a gorgeous boy, black and white. We like to call these the cow kitties because they kind of remind us of those dairy cows. But I love how his markings go right down the middle of his face. On his face, he's got black on one side, white on the other. He's just a very handsome boy and very sweet. Now, Luke is about 10 or 11 months old, just now approaching a year, so he'll be having a birthday right around the corner. And he is hanging out in C5, that's his cat condo number. He was picked up as a stray from the Lynn Haven Subdivision, and he is just ready to go find his new forever home, folks. He's such a handsome fella, and we are just hoping that somebody will go ahead and adopt him because he's been here since the beginning of May, and we don't want him to have to be here one more day, folks. He really is a very sweet boy, would make a fabulous addition to anybody's home, anybody's family, and will make you very happy to have him as a pet. So if you're interested in Luke, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control and save this sweet boy. Guys, it's like wrangling goats down here at Animal Control. We got this boy here, Kane, and he is just so excited to be here, and he's just pulling so hard on his leash, he's practically choking himself. Sounds like a little choo-choo train. Now, Kane is in B20, that's his kennel number. He's about a year old. He's a terrier mix, black and white. Looks like he was picked up as a stray from 2nd Avenue wearing a black collar, but they scanned him, no ID. And he's a good boy. He's just very excited to be here, and he sees another dog in the room, and he's just happy and wants to go play and run around the room and just have a good old time. So I do need to mention that Kane is heartworm positive, but folks, that's not the end of the road for this boy. It's something that's highly treatable by a veterinarian, and then you can get him on heartworm preventative. So if you're interested in Kane, He definitely needs a home, and he definitely needs a yard to run in so he can chase things, squirrels, chipmunks, birds, whatever it takes to keep this boy busy. He is definitely one of those that's going to want to chase some things. Maybe you can teach him to chase a ball, and hey, he may already know how to do that for all we know. But if you want Kane, then you got to come down here to Animal Control and rescue this boy, because he is down here just waiting for you. There are some kittens down here at Animal Control. This is a little group of quadruplets. We have four little babies here. Three of them have little white stripes going down the center of their little faces, and then one of them is jet black. I am holding little Steve here. He's the boy in the group. And then we have Stella, Sarah, and Samantha. And absolutely adorable little babies, folks. I tell you what, they are just as cute as they can possibly be. And I'm guessing they're about 4 weeks old. They look very, very young, but they are not nursing any longer, so they are up for adoption for sure. They were all picked up as strays from McDonald Road. There must be a lot going on McDonald Road. There's something in the water, because we have a lot of kittens down here that have all come from McDonald Road. So my goodness. But these little cutie pies are just as sweet as they can be. I love the little black and white ones with their little white tippy toes also. And then, of course, we can't forget the little jet black beauty over there, who is just as sweet as can be. But I tell you what, folks, these little honeys really need homes. And it's so much better for them to be in a home than being here at Animal Control and being kind of scared, you know, in a cage and all of that. And if you know somebody that can adopt a few, if you want to take one and then maybe three of your neighbors want to take the rest, and they can all grow up together and be happy and healthy and loving all together. And like I always like to say, cats are like potato chips. You can't just have one. So you can't just have one kitten for sure. So come on down here to Animal Control and meet these little sweethearts. And please, please, folks, consider taking one or two or more home, because they all do need their forever homes. And that is our show for today, folks. We are just hanging out here with our buddy Banner while we close the show today. He's a Chihuahua that's up for adoption here at Animal Control as well. But I just want to make sure that I mention that we are still doing our own adoptions at Petco and PetSmart. It would be PetSmart in Noonan, generally on Sundays from about 12:30 to 3:30. And then Petco in Peachtree City, I believe that is generally about 12:30 to 3:30 as well. But what you can do is you can go visit our website at nchsrescue.org and get more information about the adoption events that we're having. Also, you can find out information about fostering, volunteering, all that sort of thing, donating. All of that is on our website as well. And while you're online, go ahead and like our Facebook page, and make sure that you like the Facebook page for the Help Spay Neuter Clinic as well, because they are an affiliate of the Noonan Coweta Humane Society. We opened that facility back in 2010, and it is still going strong, a high quality, low cost spay neuter clinic. But also, guys, there are some more thank yous that I need to give. Thank you to Coweta County Animal Control for allowing us to come down to your facility, because we don't have our own standalone facility as of yet. I know some people get a little confused and think that this building is the Noonan Coweta Humane Society. We actually don't have our own shelter, but it is something that we are hoping to have in the future. It's definitely a goal of ours to be able to have our own shelter. But until then, we will continue coming down to Animal Control and showcasing the pets that are down here that are up for adoption. Also, thank you to New Link for making this show possible, for sending us Laura, who keeps us on track and on time as the best camera woman in all of Coweta County and probably all of Georgia. And thank you to our volunteers who give up their time and their love each and every week to make sure that we find homes for all of these homeless pets. And folks, we really do strive to be a no homeless pets community. That is what our goal is. We don't want to see any animals euthanized simply because they're homeless. And that's why we do what we do. So thank you so much for tuning in, folks. We hope that you have a great week, and we'll catch you next time on Adopt a Pet.